So here is Nodin, and this is our sixth session. And I'm working with the flag a little bit. So generally, when I introduce them back to the flag, I have them follow it, which I have done with him already, but unfortunately, I didn't get that on camera. But I'm going kind of into the space around him slowly with the flag. And as you can see, he kind of braces up a little bit. So I'm just gonna work on trying to get him comfortable in the space around him first until I can feel like he gets a little bit more so, like, oh, that's okay. And then we can get a release. So I'm just watching those muscles in his body, waiting for them just to give a little bit of relaxation, and then I'm gonna give the release. And again, just working on the space around him, not quite touching him yet. And just giving him the time to think about it. And then gonna give him a little bit of a rub there. Now that was a little bit of a mistake that I found where accidentally pushed the flag over to the other side, so I just figured, well, let's do a little bit of work with seeing it in our other eye. So you can see he got pretty worried, but the minute he relaxed and kind of, you can tell he turns his body into a C and he tenses up, but then the minute he can let go, I try to do the release. And so it's just him kind of linking his two eyes together, where he's like, oh, it's touching me on that side, but I see it on the other eye. I'm just gonna gently ask him to step forward, see the flag, and then try to get those feet to move forward again and follow it. Again, just trying to get that curiosity and getting him kind of used to it in the space around him. And especially with Nodin, he needs a little bit more time. So just giving him some time here. And he was nudging my elbow. So you have to be a little bit careful. You can see he's being curious and nudging with his nose here, that if they were to nip or anything like that. You know, just being mindful, but he is being very curious at the moment. So I'm just gonna see where we're going. And then he's very good. He likes the face rubs. So that's kind of how I'm rewarding him right now. And if I can get him to take a couple of steps forward, I'm going to reposition my rope and, then I'm going to go back to see if I can work on that space because you see he still kind of puts his body into that C, which is a defensive position. But you can tell he's trying to figure it out. So I'm just going to keep on asking him to take a couple of steps forward, thinking forward sometimes. And then the touch, he was actually very good there. And I'm just gonna hold it here for just a second. I don't wanna hold it too long, but I'm just watching the muscles across his back for seeing if I can. They were really tight, so I wanted to see if they would give a little bit of a relaxation. And just letting him get to see the flag, and he goes, oh my gosh, it's on my face. And just going back and forth. I know here in my head, I need to give him a little bit of a minute. Kind of think about that. And then I'm going to give him a face rub. That was really good. And then going through, and I'm able to go and touch the hind leg and get a little bit of a tail swish. So he's saying I'm not necessarily a fan of that, but he's trying very hard. And the tension in his body is getting better and better. So again, I'm gonna have him follow the flag a little bit. I'm gonna have it bounce up and down. He is a little bit of sound sensitive, so kind of the sound of the flag. So I'm gonna sit here and play with this a little bit and then give him a face rub because that was a good boy. I'm gonna work the other side. And he's getting better. He's starting to realize that it's not scary. Except for when it made the sound when I took it away. And again, I'm trying to make sure I give him lots of breaks. And now I felt like, okay, well, let's address kind of the sound of the flag. And I'm going to make sure that I'm looking away. I don't want to direct any of that energy towards him. And then when I do bring the flag back, I'm very kind of turned off. But then I'm going to ask him to send him. I'm going to direct my energy again. So it's kind of a lot of like off and on energy. Again, I'm keeping my body kind of relaxed, and then I can go in and touch him. And then when I direct, he's actually a really, really smart kid. He figured that out pretty quickly. And then trying to turn my energy off. So that was like a fun little game. And always trying to work on my body position as well. So then going back in and giving him a good little rub, telling him that he was a good boy. And so I thought that was pretty good with the flag. So now I'm gonna go in and work on picking up his feet. And he's gotten pretty good about his front feet. I'm just working on getting my body even closer. So that's kind of like the first steps. First steps are touch the leg, pick up the foot, and then you have to work on getting your body closer. So then you eventually want to be able to do the farrier stance where it is in between both legs. You see you got a little nervous there. I'm just going to give him a rub and reassure. And then he brings his head down a little bit. So there you can see I'm kind of moving in and touching him with my body. And he doesn't really mind. So that was a good boy. So we're just going to kind of hang out and give him a second. It's nice though, he's starting to kind of come in when I step away. I'm going to work on towards touching the left hind. And he was very good about picking it up. He's got a little bit of worry, so he moved away, but that's honestly, I'd rather him kind of move away. But again, he's giving me a good feeling about picking up the hind foot. It's my least favorite part of Mustang training, honestly, is picking up the back feet. But again, he's being a very good boy. And I'm feeling more comfortable with how he feels, so I'm able to walk further back. And that was really good. That time he didn't walk away when I picked up the foot. So I was pretty happy with that. So I'm going to give him a minute here, give him a nice little face rub again, and now I'll work on the right side. Sometimes it's easier when the foot is resting. However, if it's a nervous horse and the foot is resting, sometimes you have to be pretty hesitant because it's kind of like the safety's off, if that makes sense. Like their fingers on the trigger. Sometimes when they're a little nervous and that foot is cocked like that. But again, he's being a pretty good boy. He's a little bit more nervous on the right side, which is very typical, but he's still very good about it. So I gave him a nice rub because again, I'm gonna go in baby steps for that, but I was able to pick up both hind feet. So I was pretty happy with that. And just getting him to do a couple of steps forward. Always kind of working on that leading. And then giving him a face rub. So then going back. And we still want to get a little bit of a move around when I pick it up. So I'm just gonna steadily go. I just want to see if I can pick it up without him moving sideways. And I was able to pick it up a little bit and he didn't move. So I was gonna give him a good rub for that. And I'm pretty happy with how he's feeling. He's feeling pretty relaxed about when I give him the neck rubs and touching his chest and being able to pick up all 4 feet. I thought that was pretty good. And you can tell his energy has dropped. He's a lot more relaxed and coming in for a good little face rub. So I thought that was a really good session with him. And this was in the morning. So then we go to session 7, which is in the afternoon. In the afternoon, I just kind of like to groom them up a little bit, work on scratching. It's still pretty warm in Florida, so you can see he's like a little tacky. He has his winter woolies because normally where they are out west, it's a little bit more chilly at nighttime. So sometimes this can work for our benefit because they can be pretty itchy. So I'm trying to see if I can kind of get him to let down his guard by giving him some good scratches. And you can see he's got a very, very sweet, very cute personality. I'm going to see if I can find any of those itchy spots up by his ear. And I just have the curry that I'm trying to see if I can get any of the old hair off. And you can see I'm chatting with my student at the same time. And again, he seems to like the face rubs. And he's starting to really get into it. So that's kind of the really fun part is when they do finally let go and really start to enjoy all the grooming and... About right here, he does start to really get into the scratches, but then he kind of stops himself a little bit. So I thought, oh yeah, we're getting it, but then he kind of stopped. So I gave him a little bit of release. And again, I'm being pretty mindful here. I don't want him to bite my face, but again, I'm going off of a lot of feel, but he did get his first little kiss. It was pretty cute. But I don't just go around kissing their faces all the time, just as a note. But he seems to really be enjoying his little groom session. And I'm just going to keep working on here. Sometimes I can find an itchy spot in the mane. And again, I got a little bit of a spot and then he kind of stopped a little bit. And then I just hung out a little bit more and we had some cuddles. He's actually, like I said, he's very comfortable about his face and he likes those face rubs. like a lot around the all those facial nerves there. And I'm very curious to see kind of what his genetics come back for his coloring, because you can see he's got a little bit of a silver nose. And but he's a pretty cute guy personality wise. He really seems to like the attention. So we had a really nice session, and it was a good boy for Nodin.